right, let's do this one more time. My name is Rocky Rockington. I was bitten by a radioactive Lane profile picture, and for the past 10 years, I've been the one and only Rockington. I'm pretty sure you know the rest.
Oh look, one of my fans does commentaries.
I made a bunch of videos, fell in love, made more videos, I made more and more videos, and I did this.
Welcome to the Power Room, where we scan your power.
We don't really talk about this. Look, I'm Jewish, I'm bisexual, I have autism, I have an excellent taste in music, and a so-so audience. Well, I mean, I've seen worse.
You need to quit!
But after everything, I still love making videos. I mean, who wouldn't? So no matter how much drama I get myself in, I always find a way to continue. Because the only thing standing between the internet and oblivion is me. And there's only one Ington, and that's me. Huh, looks like I'm not the only one with a name that ends in Ington. I guess I may as well steal his best joke and overuse it.
I always thought I might be bad, now I'm sure that it's true. Cause I think you're so good, yet I'm nothing like you.
I know I said last time that I would change this intro to make it a little bit more, you know, other stuff than Fooly Cooly, but like, you know, I kind of feel like keeping it this way, mainly because of the fact that, you know, I just kind of feel like it. Anyway, so this is Chazington, best YouTuber of all time, which is quite shocking, honestly, because like, he didn't have a YouTube channel in the 2000s or early 2010s. I say this mainly because YouTube is just filled with a bunch of garbage nowadays. Then here comes Chazington, actually making good content and sometimes even calling out these people who make shit content. Okay, only one time, but still. This one time when he ended up actually calling out these people, he chose the perfect people to be called out for their shit. Unlike a lot of other people on YouTube who claim to be cleaning up YouTube, they always pick the lowest hanging fruit, basically content that barely anyone ever sees. But with this video right here by Chazington, he's actually talking about a real YouTube epidemic. Hell, this trend that he's talking about in this video right here, it was so bad that it legitimately drove me insane for a little bit. I pretty much went full Joker mode when I saw that my entire recommended was filled with this garbage. It wasn't until I almost attempted suicide that the advertisers on Google saw what I was doing and was all like, you know, let's clean up his recommended a little bit. I know you're watching, Google. Sometimes they like to jump scare me with their Alexa knockoff. But regardless, we're gonna do a response video to this video made by Chazington, mainly because I want to highlight how good it is. I mean, hell, who says that I'm not allowed to make a positive response video? Noodle Tones? She's not even around anymore!
They always list the people who have analyzed the video, but then just start listing shit the criminal might be thinking because they rubbed their head or something. It's always a self-soothing method.
He starts to cry, but if you're wondering if he's actually upset, notice that he gets distracted and has to brush his hair out of his face.
It feels like it's always jumping to conclusions because there's not actually that much to say over this fucking 3-hour-long confession video.
I love how Chazington pointed this out, mainly because of the fact that this is just a thing that's been plaguing YouTube for an extremely long time. I mean, hell, people are claiming that Cyrax is constantly lying all the time just because his eyes are closed sometimes. Well, yeah, I am gonna agree, Cyrax isn't really a reliable narrator since there are a lot of stuff about his story that has been proven wrong. At the same time, closing his eyes isn't proof that he's lying. The fact that he's lying is proof that he's lying, when that does eventually come out.
There's so many of these Daniel Larson videos from these, like, fucking lolcow channels I love watching, and they always just play these Daniel Larson, like, long-ass clips. I clicked on the video to get a summary. I don't need to see the Daniel Larson fucking haircut incident again.
My inspiration behind this haircut, I wanted it to look like Arnold Schwarzenegger got struck by lightning, just like Albert Einstein.
Not to mention, it's just kind of lazy. Like, I know why you do it. It's not for documentation purposes.
Keep in mind the fact that Chasington has worked with Club Doom in the past, so this just goes to show that Chasington actually cares, especially since he's, you know, actually criticizing the lolcow community. I wonder what Club Doom will think of this video. Chasington, you're not being very virtuous! You know, it's probably something like that. Also, can we talk about how Okiwi isn't a thing that exists? Especially now that we're on the topic of lolcows. I looked on Kiwi Farms and there was no result. Keep in mind, even on Kiwi Farms, trolls are mentioned just as much as lolcows themselves. Hell, I'm even in a server dedicated to discussing lolcows. I was in the server back when I still thought lolcows were funny, and I only chose not to leave mainly because of the fact that, you know, I thought it'd be convenient just in case if I had any questions. And lo and behold, it ended up being true. Okiwi does not exist. I genuinely don't understand why people have to LARP in order to spread fear. Like, all it does is make you look stupid. And yes, there will be more talk of LARPing throughout this video.
I probably sound nitpicky as fuck, because I am, but it is a big turnoff with these videos. Especially when the subject matter isn't really interesting or thrilling and more just sad and depressing.
That's the crazy thing too, like, you got all these people showing up in Willard's comment section and like pretending that what was going on in the video that he made about me was like funny in any way, shape, or form when literally it was the aftermath of a suicide attempt. It's kind of funny because like he uploaded that video, right, expecting to like, you know, have the status quo stay the same. Meanwhile, Chasington comes in a month later, exposes all of this bullshit, and gets way more views than his original video. Hell, even my video where I exposed the truth myself got more views than his video he made.
They do this a lot where they will just show like the worst case of grieving and shock in these thumbnails, and it just comes off as kind of gross and manipulative. The worst channel in this case is the Misery Machine. I almost don't want to show these in my funny little video, but the titles won't be like the case of evil Mr. Bones. Instead, front and center, it's pictures of the victims and like the horrifying ways they died. I know that these stories are important and the awful things should not be swept under the rug, and I also don't really agree with YouTube censorship, but I also don't really think these are being done with the most respect.
This week's episode has been brought to you by Murder by Choice, a fully interactive murder mystery adventure set on a tropical island in modern time. This week's episode has been brought to you by Love and Pies, a free-to-play merge-to-mobile game that delivers an experience that rivals the excitement of a gripping TV series or a page-turning book.
This week's episode has been brought to you by Lots of Slots, a free-to-play mobile slots game that you can play anywhere and anytime.
When you cut from your story about the worst trauma a human can experience to your shitty, like, casino slop game on the App Store now,
There's actually more reason as to why this feels as disrespectful as it does, besides the shitty sponsorships. It's genuinely because of the fact that they just don't care. I know we established this earlier in the video, but, you know, this point right here just proves it even further.
And the thumbnails are so fucking stupid and funny. They always edit guns into them, but then I see ones where they edit in actual children. Like, this never happened in the actual footage. That's edited in. That's not fucking good.
And they do this shit purely just to virtue signal. And no, I'm not just talking about the people uploading those types of videos. I'm also talking about the people who consume them. And yes, the fact that I use the word consume in this case is very intentional. The people uploading the videos wants to pretend to be a good person by saying, "You see, we're exposing pedophiles." While the people watching the videos want to pretend to be a good person by saying, "Oh, we hate pedophiles. Look at the content we watch." This is just a similar thing that all these acronym-related groups get involved in.
Alright, I just want to add a little bit here. I found this channel called Detective Williams. The description is very interesting. Let's just read this here. "Retired detective who doesn't like the current state of policing, looking over interrogations and body cam footage. How much do you want to bet? that this man is a real detective.
Being a police officer isn't an easy job, as they're often exposed to all sorts of threats and danger. In today's case, fentanyl.
You know, it's kind of insane how a lot of these people don't know how fentanyl actually works, despite the fact that they always use it as an excuse to tell people not to like something.
And then immediately I looked at the newest video, and what's that?
Bingo.
You fucking stole the stupid... You stole that guy's thumbnail. The thumbnail's fucking wrong. That's some random guy. Maybe I'm the real fucking detective. I'm the one who found where this is from.
You know, it's absolutely insane how the person who's not LARPing ends up being better at what they do than the person who is LARPing. Also, unrelated example, but every time someone gets caught LARPing, they always backpedal.
Don't ever call me a Nazi again! I am not a Nazi!
And yes, I have experience with people LARPing as police officers or detectives or whatever as well.
Mate is online, and guess what? If I'm gonna call Mate right here.
Yeah, dude.
Is that all you got? Is that all you got? Is
and
that all you got?
Gonna
that?
Oh, damn. He's gonna track you, bitch. So he don't fuck with us.
You tried to fuck with me. You tried to fuck with us. We'll fuck with you.
Mate did.
He traced their fucking IP. Yes.
Yes. I'm not gonna say what it is because you'll be shocked.
I mean, I know where he previously lived.
So yeah, consider this as a warning, bitch.
Bitch ass little pedophile looking motherfucking piece of shit, bitch cunt.
Yeah, and also, anyone who lives near Florida, find his place and beat him up.
Well, I wouldn't want that.
Yes.
I wouldn't want that for him. I don't want him to get beaten up. Like, I fucking hate this dude, but I wouldn't want that.
Yeah.
Everybody hates this guy. And for the fact that he wants to beat the fuck up, beat Leon on it and everyone else, that's the last fucking thing that he wants to do. And we're not the ones that we should be fucked with. Not Leon, not Dice, or me, or Spyro, or even anyone else.
And apparently... thinks I doxed him or some shit like that, as I don't know where the fuck he's got that shit from.
Chasington, if you're watching this, and believe me when I say that if anyone has the right to say if you're watching this to anyone, it'd be you, because you probably most likely are, then I would recommend looking in the description of this video to get more context for what happened in that previous clip.
This genre is so weird to me, I almost want to call it disrespectful. This is kind of in the same group of true crime, but this video really pisses me off. DuckED reacts to the Junko Furuta case. It's the shitty upload of a stream where this guy watches a video explaining one of the worst cases in Japan about a girl who was tortured and killed, and he's going in like full pog on the thumbnail, his chat is telling him to turn it off, and all that he adds is this.
And attracted a lot of attention, which made some people jealous.
Oh no.
She didn't.
He's just going like, yep, that's bad. Of course it's fucking bad! At least the original video was educational in some way. You already streamed your reaction. Do you really need to then upload that to YouTube for more money? It feels ghoulish and inhuman. Maybe he meant well or something, but you gotta realize this helps no one but yourself. And I keep seeing reaction videos like these. What is this? Watching the worst car crashes because I like to suffer. Oh, I like to suffer. Apparently I do too. This is like that one Germa joke where people keep saying he loves watching car crash compilations, but it's just real.
And the funny thing about it is too, is that when you point out how disingenuous these types of people are when they make content like this, they usually react like this.
I have contained my rage for as long as possible, but I shall unleash my fury upon you like the crashing of a thousand waves! Begone, vile man! Begone from me!
Okay, so this is the part where you usually hear the commentary channel say, final thoughts, but like, in this case, I'm not gonna do that, mainly because of the fact that you already get the point. So instead, I'm gonna end the video like this.
I always thought I might be bad.
Now, Soundwave. I ain't even sure where to start with your video, but...
Other than that, you guys have a great day. Thank you very much for checking out this video. Solo lost money. Raylos are weird. Fuck Naughty Dog.
Hey! Yo! Fuck you! You fucking dick!